For those of you new to our channel, we are Rhonda and Joe with RVing with the Moracas.
After we left Assateauge, we stayed at Kiptopeke State Park, just north of the Chesapeake Bay Bridge Tunnel in Cape Charles, Virginia. This is a beautiful park. We made a reservation to stay at the park online. Half of the sites could be specifically reserved. The rest of were assigned upon arrival. We were not assigned a campsite, but got to pick one once we got there. As you can see from the video, we arrived a little later than we would have liked to, and it was getting dark. We drove through the campground and selected Site 9 because it appeared to be level. Some of the sites in the middle had an incline, and these sites would have been difficult for us to get our RV level. The campground has 138 sites with full hookups, and the cost was a bit high for us. It was $50.74 per night. We were there on Halloween weekend, and campers were dressed in costume, and there were lots of decorations, and the campground was packed. The park has a lot to offer. They have lodges, cabins, yurts, bunkhouses, and camping. There's a nice beach, fishing, kayaking, hiking trails, and a boat ramp. Unfortunately for us, it rained the day we drove there and much of the next day as we were still getting the remnants of Hurricane Zeta. The park is full of signs and informational plaques that tell the story of John Smith, an Englishman who explored the Chesapeake Bay region in the 1600s. The area was home to over 50,000 American Indians who shared the bountiful supply of resources back then. One of the Indians' towns visited by John Smith was Accohannock, and the chief's name was Kiptopeke, the name for the state park. This is a very interesting barrier here. These look like concrete ships.
So they were made for World War II when steel got real expensive, and they figured out they could make ships that worked with cement.
Wow.
So that's what these were, and then when, you know, once the war was over, I'm sure they stopped using them, and there they are. Chesapeake Bay.
So we walked down this really pretty, it's called Osprey Boardwalk, and it comes out to the beach, and we can see seven ships heading in somewhere, or away somewhere. I'm not sure where they're going. I don't know if you can see them in the video, but it's pretty cool looking. This is a nice little boardwalk. I really like these raised trails. Another cool find in the park is the remnants of the Turin's Motor Lodge. So we're out walking with Kiptopeke State Park. Joe's sure I'm mispronouncing it, and he's probably right. Yesterday it rained all day long, so we stayed inside and worked on the video and got some things done indoors. It was a pretty nice, relaxing day. We made banana pineapple bread. It's kind of cold, and since it was rainy, it just kind of felt like we needed to do some baking. Warmed up the RV with the oven. Today we're out getting our steps in. This is a beautiful park, and I think the summertime would be a great time to return and do some kayaking and exploring the water trails along the Chesapeake Bay and learn more about the area. We should have ample opportunity since we have family along this route and hope to explore the area more in the future. Our last night in the park was very unsettling. We heard the bedroom slide awning being blown in the wind. We finally got up and shut the slide because we did not want the awning to get damaged. Also, the magna shades on the side windows of the RV were getting beat by the wind and made a lot of noise. I did not realize this was the noise I was hearing until the next morning. Luckily, there was no damage to the magna shades or the windows. I spoke with other campers the next morning, and they had brought in their slides also during the night. As luck would have it, Hurricane Zeta caught up to us on our final day in the park. The winds became very strong, and the Chesapeake Bay Bridge Tunnel was closed to motorhomes due to high winds, and we had to wait to cross the bridge. The park rangers were very accommodating and allowed us to stay in the park until the winds died down. Later in the afternoon, we were able to cross, but Joe had to drive very slowly all the way across the bridge and under the tunnels. The bridge is beautiful, but we did not really enjoy this crossing as much as we had other times when we had to cross the bridge. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like the video and subscribe if you're new to our channel.
Feel free to leave us a comment and tell us what you think. We'll be happy to respond.